Welcome students. So today I will be discussing the next part of the chapter, the overcoat from MCB written by Nikolai Gogol. So in my previous video I had discussed about a middle-aged Russian counselor, Akaki Akakievich, who was a very silent person and he was very dutiful. He worked hard and he was very enthusiastic. But he did not dress up properly and he always used to work. So people used to backbite him and the young officials laughed at him and made fun of him by throwing bits of paper over his head, calling them snow. But in spite of that, it had no effect upon his work. He used to work continuously and he never made a single mistake. But due to the freezing cold, as winter had already set in, so he had a thin overcoat which made everyone laugh, and they used to call this overcoat as a dressing jacket. So hearing this, he thought of buying. First he thought to go to the tailor Petrovich to get it mended, but the tailor told him that he needs to buy a new overcoat. So hearing this, he thought of cutting his expenditure, right? Like dispense with tea in the evening, to burn no candles, and if there was anything which he must do, to go into his landlady's room and work by her light. So when he went into the street, he must walk as lightly as he could and as cautiously upon the stones, almost upon tiptoe, in order not to wear his heels down. In too short a time, he must give the laundress as little to wash, because the dresses will become less dirty, in order not to wear out his clothes. So as soon as he reached home, he used to take the clothes off and wore only his cotton dressing gown, which he saved very carefully. So in this way, another 2 or 3 months of partial fasting, he used to have very less food, like he used to skip 1 or 2 meal in a day. Akakievich had actually saved up nearly 80 rubles. So the very first day he set up in company with Petrovich to the shop. They bought some very good clothes. So he was very excited that he will have a new overcoat. So it is difficult to say precisely on what day, but probably the most glorious one in Akaki Akakievich's life, when Petrovich at length brought home the overcoat. Finally the day arrived when Petrovich brought his new overcoat. He brought it in the morning before the hour when it was necessary to start for the department, before goes to his workstation. Never did an overcoat arrive so exactly in the nick of time, means exactly on time. For the severe cold had set in and it seemed to threaten to increase. Petrovich brought the overcoat himself, as befits a good tailor. On his countenance was a significant expression such as Akaki Akakievich had never beheld there. He seemed fully sensible that he had done no small deed and crossed a gulf separating tailors who only put in linings and execute repairs from those who make new things. Now taking out the overcoat, he looked proudly at it. Akaki Akakievich looked proudly at the overcoat which Petrovich brought for him. Then he pulled it and fitted it down behind with his hand, and he draped it around Akaki Akakievich without buttoning it. Akaki Akakievich, like an experienced man, wished to try the sleeves. Petrovich helped him on with them and it turned out that the sleeves were satisfactory also, so everything fitted him. In short, the overcoat appeared to be perfect. So the Petrovich stitched it perfectly. And most seasonably he paid him, thanked him and set out at once in his new cloak for the department, means for his workstation. So Akaki paid Petrovich, thanked him and set out at once in his wearing his new overcoat for this workstation where he used to work. Petrovich followed him and, pausing in the street, gazed long at the overcoat in the distance, after which he went to one side expressly to run through a crooked alley and emerged again into the street beyond to gaze once more upon the overcoat from another point. So he used to look at the overcoat from different points. He was looking at Akaki Akakievich. Once more upon the overcoat from another point, namely directly in front. So the summary of the overcoat goes in this way. So this is a short story written by Nikolai Gogol. So what is the summary of the story? The story narrates the tale of Akaki Akakievich, a small red-haired middle-aged Russian counselor. Akakievich was a quiet man who silently went about his work in spite of being bullied by his co-workers. He did not care for anything except his work. Even his clothes were old and disheveled. He only had a thin cloak to protect him from the freezing Russian winter. This cloak was an object of ridicule to his co-workers because of its poor condition, and they used to laugh at him, make fun of him. One day Akakievich decides to take it to a tailor to get it mended, but the tailor asks him to throw the wretched garment and buy a new cloak. Akakievich is dismayed. He felt sad because he has no money for a new cloak. He spends the next few weeks saving money by curtailing some of his usual expenses. When the tailor brings his new coat home, it's the best day of Akakievich's life. He proudly looks at the silk-lined cloak and deems it to be the perfect one. Then Akakievich tries it on and sets out at once to his office so he can show it off to his colleagues and put an end to their teasing. So children, read the chapter thoroughly. Read 2 to 3 times, and if there is any doubt, please ask me in the live class. Thank you, children.